big pharma is spending billions, we know that, to develop treatments for brain disorders.
Right.
Which companies stand to benefit the most if this money is approved?
Yeah, well, this is basically, at this point, a research initiative. But Obama did not want it to be lost on everyone that there's a business economic element to this as well. He wants this to be about the economy and jobs. So they're hoping that from this basic research initiative, it's going to spawn a lot of keys to new treatments and new initiatives. So some of the companies that are really big in neuroscience right now, Pfizer, Roche, Eli Lilly, they're among the real leaders in neuroscience research. But there's so much we don't know about the brain that a lot of this, these billions of dollars they have spent have sort of gone to waste.
And Shannon, you've been reporting really in the past year pretty consistently about actually how hard it is for startups, for venture capitalists to raise money in this field because there's so much possibility of failure. It's also so expensive. There's not a lot of investors who are willing to go near this space.
Right.
Would this money change that?
The hope is that yes. The hope is that one, there might be some grants that could go to private companies to help them. For example, Obama pointed out that Google got some of their early research funding from the National Science Foundation. So that's one area. But another area, if we can learn more about the brain, if we can find better ways to sort of decode what's going on in the brain, it's going to become a lot easier to develop drugs. And researchers are going to want to invest in that more. Venture capitalists are going to want to put more money in that. The hope is that it could make it cheaper and more efficient to study new drugs and that could start drawing more investment into this area of neuroscience.
Okay, so we're obviously talking about neuroscience, but there's a link to Google as well that the president spoke about. What's this triangle effect?
Well, not only Google, but a lot of companies, anyone doing a GPS using computer chips, using a printer, you know, Obama really emphasized that spending, the importance of spending on basic research to helping build companies that are going to stay here. And he pointed out Google getting some of their early funding from the government to help them start off.
So basically he's trying to say, listen up, okay, this money is earmarked, but it's not a mistake. Look at other companies that have received federal funding that have actually contributed to the U.S. economy.
That's the argument. That this whole mapping the brain is not about some researchers sitting in a government lab playing around with, you know, test tubes and beakers and high sensors. That there's an economic element to this as well. That it can come up with, you know, new treatments that companies can use to start a business, to make lots of money. It can come up with cures for people. That he's really hoping that this is a stimulus as well as, you know, some great science we're going to be able
to
do.
Okay, so here's the $100 million question. How likely is it that that amount of money is accepted by Congress? How likely is it that this passes?
Yes. So here's the big caveat. This is in Obama's proposed budget for 2014. That has to go to Congress, of course. Now, everybody in Congress, you know, one of the things they can agree on is science, medicine, great research. But when we're squeezing $5 million here and $2 million there, $100 million isn't big money, obviously, in the federal government. But when everyone's looking for little projects to cut, no one really knows if this is going to get through Congress, which it has to, or else all of this we're talking about, you know, is going to be a moot point. Exactly.